The last Photoshop script I showed was Crop to Margins, a variation of the free AutoCrop script. Crop to Margins doesn't worry about the ultimate size, only the margins based on subject size. But what if you want a certain size, and with defined margins, that don't have to be equal, a limitation of AutoCrop? I made a new script to do it. Crop to Template. I'll show the script in Windows. It works the same on macOS. Perhaps you've seen my free script, Fit to Guides. That script works on one image and scales whatever is selected to fit within guides the user adds. This new script does the same, but does it to a batch of images. For each image, select subject is used to make a selection that is scaled to fit inside the guides of a template. First, you need a template document, the desired size, and with guides for the margins. For example, my template is 2,000 pixels square, with guides 200 pixels in all around. The margins don't have to be equal. Make them whatever you like. Before I show the script, I'm going to change the background color. You'll see why in a moment. To run the script, open the Actions panel. I already have an action to run the script. For help adding scripts to Photoshop, see the link in the description for another video that shows the steps. In the Actions list, select Crop to Template. Click the Actions panel Play button. First, select whether to process an open image or a folder of images. I don't have anything open other than the template, so the choice is disabled. Click the Folder button to select the location of images to crop. Enable the option Include Subfolders if desired. The next section is Options. Select the template to use from the list of open documents. If you want, the guides can be included in the output images. Or not, your choice. When a subject is taller than wide, it's always centered. But subjects wider than tall, there is the choice of how to align the subject vertically. Choose top, middle, or bottom. Depending on the image and desired margins, sometimes there isn't enough image to fill the template. In that case, there is the choice to use content-aware fill. For now, I'll leave it disabled. I'll show its effect later in the video. In the Output section, click the button Folder to select where to save the cropped images. Then choose the file format to use. Choices are JPEG, PNG, PSD, or TIFF. Flatten removes any transparency. For JPEG, this option is disabled because it always flattens. JPEG also has the option Quality. This works just like the Photoshop Save dialog. Next is Convert to Profile. Enable if desired and choose a profile. Then cropped images are converted to the selected profile. Original File Name Plus lets you add a suffix to each image output. Click OK and the script gets to work. The script opens each image in the folder, fits the subject into the template guides, and saves the image in the format selected. When done, the script lets us know the results. In this case, there were some concerns, so a log file was written to the output folder. Click Yes to open the log. Some images were less than crop. The remedy depends on the original image. Because this one started flattened, the current background color was added. But these others were layered images, which become white once flattened. If not flattened, the extra is transparent. I'll show that in a bit. Now let's have a look in Bridge. Here's why I changed the background color. It helps make clear where these images came up short and the background color was added. For this batch of images, I'd set the background to white. Or you might have images with a gray or cream background, for example. Then set the background to a matching value. Or there's another solution. Use content-aware fill. And the log indicates content-aware fill was used. See the results in Bridge. Next, let's see how the results differ when images are not flattened. Here in the input folder, the last three are layered PSDs with transparent backgrounds. I'll run the script again. This time, disable content-aware fill, output PSD, and don't flatten. We're still alerted that some images are less than crop. For images that started out flattened, the result is the same. But the layered images add transparency instead. And keep all original layers. Get the script at the link in the description. Like this video if you found it helpful, and subscribe so you're notified of future videos. Any problem with the script, or ideas for others, leave a comment. All suggestions are welcome. There are plenty of other scripts and videos for them. Click the video or playlist on screen for more. Thank you for watching. We'll do it again soon.